Dear all, welcome to the presentation on gas flow cycle in the subject of thermal fluid science. In earlier lecture, we understood the procedure for energy calculations as well as this exergy evaluation of a typical Brayton cycle used in a gas power plant. The procedure is explained using JANAF tables in place of a basic thermodynamic approach. This lecture is focused to understand the numerical solution of this energy as well as exergy evaluation of the same Brayton cycle using JANAF tables. Therefore, this presentation is focused to demonstrate the earlier explanation through the example of numerical solution. The numerical solution is explained in a step-by-step manner. The problem is as follows. Solve the energy and exergy performance of a Brayton cycle with the following particulars. Efficiency of the electrical generator is 98%. Mechanical efficiency of the gas turbine 95%. Mechanical efficiency of the air compressor is 98%. Atmospheric condition is taken as 25 degrees centigrade and 1.01325 bar. Air flow rate in the compressor is 1 kg per second. The plant pressure ratio and turbine inlet temperature are 10 and 1400 Kelvin respectively. The products of combustion expand through the turbine to a pressure of 1.1 bar. Pleiotropic stage efficiency of the compressor and turbine is taken as 91% and 87.5% respectively. The pressure drop in combustion chamber is neglected. Similarly, heat losses in combustion chamber and turbine are not accounted. The natural gas composition is collected from a typical gas power plant in India. The volume fraction of natural gas is as follows. Methane 90.81%, ethane 2.96%, propane 2.7%, I-butane 0.54%, N-butane 0.76%, I-pentane 0.2%, N-pentane 0.16%, N-hexane 0.27%, carbon dioxide 1.49%, and nitrogen 0.09% by volume. The basic Brayton cycle consists of mainly three components. They are air compressor, gas turbine combustion chamber, and gas turbine. The process are shown in TS diagram. 1, 2 is air compression, 2 to 3 is a combustion, 3 to 4 is expansion in a gas turbine. 4 to 5 is required for in case of the plant is extended to the combined cycle mode. The 4-5 is the heat recovery, which is not included in the solution. The first component, air compressor, is solved using JANAF tables, that's a gas property tables. The formula used for this air compressor is delta S is equal to 0 for isentropic compression process. To solve this compression, initially, in the first step, isentropic compression is evaluated to find the exit temperature, which is T2 dash. After getting T2 dash using isentropic efficiency, the actual temperature T2 is simulated. So the entropy terms in this delta S is equal to 0 is entropy of oxygen at T2 dash. Minus entropy of oxygen at atmospheric conditions, which is 0 in this case. and entropy of nitrogen at T2 dash and entropy of nitrogen at T1. And the last two term considers the entropy effect due to the pressure change. It's minus R log P2 by P1. In chemical reaction of combustion, 1 kg of air is considered here. That's why 1 kg of air is equal to 0.21 kg of oxygen and 0.79 kg of nitrogen. That's 21% by volume of oxygen and 79% of volume is nitrogen in atmospheric air. So the isentropic efficiency for the second step is required. It is determined from compression, that's pressure ratio of the compressor, specific heat ratio, that's a gamma, which is 1.4 for atmospheric air, and polytropic stage efficiency. The isentropic efficiency of compressor is determined from these three variables given data, which is equal to 0.88 for the compressor. To start this iteration, initially one temperature is required, that is T2 dash. Instead of randomly assuming this T2 dash, that can be calculated from the thermodynamic relations. In ideal case, T2 dash by T1 is equal to P2 by P1 whole power gamma minus 1 by gamma. It gives the initial assumption of T2 dash which is equal to 575.63 Kelvin. So this initial guess is substituted in the delta S, and that resultant delta S is equal to 0.3426. It should be close to zero. That's why the temperature is iterated. By changing this value, finally at T2 dash is equal to 569.19 Kelvin, the resultant delta S is equal to 0.001, which is close to zero. So at the T2 dash enthalpy is determined here 8041.6 kilosols per kg mole, and enthalpy at the inlet of compressor is zero because this is dead state, that is atmospheric conditions of 25 degrees centigrade and 1.01325 bar. For the second step, efficiency of isentropic efficiency of the compressor is determined in the earlier formula. So from efficiency of the compressor H1 and H2 dash, H2 is determined. The determined H2 is 9163.2 kilojoules per kg mole. This H2 is used to determine the temperature and the exit of the compressor, which is T2. But again, initially to start this iteration using this JANAF tables, one guess is required. Again, the guess is determined from the thermodynamics principles of this, assuming Cp is constant, substituting H2 is equal to H1 plus H2 dash minus H1 by efficiency compressor. Similarly, T2 is equal to T1 plus T2 dash minus T1 by efficiency of the compressor. So the initial guess is 607 Kelvin. The iteration is carried out by changing the temperature from initial guess of 607 Kelvin. At 607 Kelvin, the resultant enthalpy is 9191.7. Against the original enthalpy of 9163.2. There is a difference between these two enthalpies. That's why it is iterated by changing the temperature. At 606.06 Kelvin, the resultant enthalpy is 9163.8, which is close to the enthalpy at the exit of compressor. So at 606.06 Kelvin, the enthalpy can be determined. This is the enthalpy after real compression, the using isentropic efficiency, that is 9163.8. The specific out power, that is, which is work input to the compressor, is determined by delta S, that is same like 9163.8 minus 0. The second component is a combustion chamber. In combustion chamber, the full combustion of natural gas is considered without taking any dissociation effects. The chemical formula is framed by taking the combustion of natural gas with the compressed air, and the resultant composition consists of carbon dioxide, water vapor, oxygen and nitrogen. Since the combustion happened at excess of oxygen, the products of combustion consist of oxygen. The natural gas composition is considered from the numerical given numerical problem. The coefficients of natural gas in chemical reaction is A1 to A10. These are determined from this gas composition. Air is consist of oxygen and nitrogen. For 1 kg of air, 0.21 kg of oxygen and 0.79 kg of nitrogen is taken. Here X is the total kg of air. And B1, B2, B3, B4 are coefficients of carbon dioxide, water vapor, oxygen and nitrogen respectively in the combustion chamber. So here there are 5 unknowns, that is B1, B2, B3, B4 is 4 unknowns and X is the 5th unknown. These 5 unknowns are determined from 5 equations. Out of 5 equations, 4 are mass balance equations, that is resulted from C balance, H balance, O balance and N balance, and 5th framed equation is energy balance equation. A1 to A10 are coefficients of natural gas determined from the gas composition. So the total kg mole of natural gas is 1, that is 100%, means this is equal to, sum is equal to A1 plus A2 plus A10 is equal to, so on, equal to 1 kg mole. The mass of the fuel for 1 kg mole of natural gas is also equal to molecular weight. It's multiplied from coefficients, natural gas coefficients and subsequent molecular weight. So the resultant mass of the fuel is 18.58 kg per kg mole of the fuel. Our molecular weight of natural gas is 18.58. Energy of the fuel is higher heating value in this case. The higher heating value is determined from enthalpy of formation of natural gas composition. The resultant higher heating value is from the enthalpy of formation using gas table C is kilojoules per kg mole. By using this molecular weight, the energy of the fuel from kilojoules per kg mole is converted into kilojoules per kg, that is 52,202 kilojoules per kg. Similarly, exergy of the natural gas is determined from standard exergy of this natural gas composition from the JANAF tables, which is again converted into kilojoules per kg, that is 49,626 kilojoules per kg. Now, to determine this energy and exergy values of natural gas, the air, the value of X is assumed for supplied air around 30 to start the solution for chemical reaction. So the mass balance of chemical reaction is that is C balance, H balance, N balance, O balance, results four equations. These four equations are framed to find B1, B2, B3 and B4. But here x is unknown, that's why one more equation is required and supplied from the energy balance equations. So for the energy balance, enthalpy of the fuel is determined from enthalpy of formation of natural gas. In kg, kilojoules per kg mole of the fuel, it is minus 81,906. Similarly, enthalpy of air is also determined from enthalpy of oxygen and nitrogen. The enthalpy of formation of oxygen and nitrogen is zero. And from the sensible enthalpy of this oxygen and nitrogen, it is 9163.3 kilojoules per kg mole of air. The enthalpy of reactants is sum of enthalpy of the fuel and enthalpy of the air. And on right hand side, the enthalpy of products is the sum of enthalpy of carbon dioxide, water vapor, oxygen and nitrogen. So the value of x is determined from chemical reaction, that is energy balance equation in chemical reaction. Initially the value of x is substituted and the enthalpy of reactants and enthalpy of products is determined from the value of x, and that is LHS minus RHS should be equal to zero at the value of initial gas. It is difference is 21,578, which is away from zero, and x is iterated, and finally at the value of x 30.82, the difference of this LHS and RH is 0.0001. This is obtained as per the initial input of consistency. So finally at the value of x 30.82, enthalpy of reactants and enthalpy of products is coming as 2,540 kilojoules per kg mole. After the iteration, the results are x is equal 30.82, B3 is 4.28, B4 24.35. The total spaces in gas composition is 31.90. The gas composition resulted is carbon dioxide 3.6%, water vapor 6.64%, oxygen 13.41%, nitrogen 76.34%. The air fuel ratio is equal to mass of the air by mass of the fuel. After determined, this value is 47.83. So the following is the resulted combustion equation at the pressure ratio of 10 and 1400 Kelvin. After substituting the values of coefficients of this natural gas, air and gas composition, this is the final chemical reaction in the combustion chamber. Here x is 30.82 and B1, B2, B3, B4 are substituted, and all A1 to A10, the coefficients also substituted for the natural gas. And third component in the gas power plant is the gas turbine. Gas turbine is solved similar to an air compressor. It is also solved in three steps. And first step, isentropic expansion is solved. In second step, actual expansion of the gas is solved. The isentropic efficiency of gas turbine is determined from this pressure ratio, volumetric stage efficiency, and adiabatic index. So the polytropic from the polytropic stage efficiency, that is it given as 87.5, gamma is 1.4, the pressure ratio is 10 here, and the resultant isentropic efficiency of the gas turbine is 0.91. And initial guess of T4 dash also determined from the thermodynamic relations, that is T4 dash by T3 is equal to P4 by P3 whole power gamma minus 1 by gamma. It's T4 dash is equal 742.35 Kelvin. So for isentropic expansion, the delta S is equal 0, that is S3 minus S4 dash is equal 0, where S3 is the entropy of product gas at T3, and S4 dash is the entropy of product gas at T4 dash and P4. These two entropies are determined from the gas tables. After substituting the entropy values determined at T3 and T4 dash, and the resultant delta S is 108.31. S3 is fixed here since the T3 is constant, that is the 1400 Kelvin. The variable is S4 dash, that is T4 dash. T4 dash is iterated till getting the delta S is equal to 0. So at 823.38 Kelvin, the delta S is equal to 0.01, which is close to 0. So the final temperature is for the isentropic expansion is 823.28. At this temperature, the enthalpy are determined from the gas composition. H3 is 11,65,400 and H4 dash is 5,23,150 kilojoules per kg mole. For the second step of this solution, isentropic efficiency is determined, and from isentropic efficiency, H3 and H4 dash, H4 is determined. The H4 is equal to 5,82,980 kilojoules per kg mole. So this H4 is useful to find the T4. The initial temperature of this T4 for the iteration is determined from thermodynamic equation, that is 877.1 Kelvin. The iteration shows at initial guess of T4 877.1, the enthalpy is 5,80,250, but the actual enthalpy is 5,82,980 kilojoules per kg mole. So the temperature to be iterated to reach the required enthalpy at 879.65 Kelvin, the resultant enthalpy is 5,82,980, which is almost equal to H4. Here the fractions are not shown. These are all are iterated at JANAF tables, using JANAF tables. So the enthalpies are determined at H4, that's T3 and T4 and T2. These are the resultant enthalpy values. After substituting this enthalpy, the specific work of compressor, specific work of turbine is determined. The specific net output is also determined from specific work of turbine and specific work of compressor. So finally, the specific output is nearly 3 lakhs. After rounding, it is 3 lakhs kilojoules per kg mole. These are all our specific values. But the given amount of air is not in terms of kg moles. It is given in SIMS, that is 1 kg per second, that is air flow rate. So the chemical reaction is linearized by multiplying one multiplication factor. So multiplication factor is determined by equating mass of air MA is equal to multiplication factor into x into 0.21 of molecular weight of oxygen and 0.79 of molecular weight of nitrogen. This ratio gives the multiplication factor for air that is equal to 0.0011. So this multiplication factor is multiplied in both the left hand side of the equation as well as the right hand side of the equation. So all these values of kilojoules, as well as this kilojoules is multiplied by this multiplication factor. So the total power generation is equal to the considered by total works of this compressor as well as the total works of gas turbine. The total work of this air compressor is equal to 324.1 kilowatts obtained from this multiplication factor as well as this mechanical efficiency of the compressor. Similarly, the turbine output, the total turbine output is 609.8 kilowatts determined from this multiplication factor as well as generator efficiency and mechanical efficiency of the turbine. The net output from the gas turbine is algebraic sum of turbine and compressor, which is equal to 285.6 kilowatts. So the thermal efficiency is the ratio of output by input. The output is 285.6 kilowatts and input is heating value, higher heating value, and also it is also multiplied to meet the airflow rate of 1 kg per second, and also the multiplication factor. After substituting all these values, the resultant thermal efficiency is 26.18%. So this is the energy relations, and energy performance is calculated. Next step is exergy evaluation. In exergy evaluation, the entropy is required at each and every state of the plant, that is S1, S2, S3, S4. All these entropies are determined at the temperature of T1, T2, T3, T4 respectively, as well as this P1, P2, P3, P4. At dead state, the S1 is equal to 0 as per our earlier discussion. And mole fraction of this carbon dioxide, water vapor, nitrogen, so oxygen and nitrogen also determine. The total exergy of any chemical species is the sum of chemical exergy and physical exergy. So the chemical exergy of air is determined from the formula, that is 3960.7 kilojoules per kg mole. This is the chemical exergy is determined from the standard exergy data available from the gas property, and physical exergy of air at each and every state, that's before compression and after compression, is determined. Physical exergy is above 25 degrees centigrade is at inlet is 0 and exit is determined at T2, which is 264,880 kJ per kg. And the physical exergy is equal to H minus T0 into S. So enthalpy value and entropy values are substituted to get the physical exergy of air at the exit of the compressor. And physical exergy of the gas at the exit of combustion chamber is also determined by using enthalpy and entropy at T3, that is equal to 872,900 kJ per kg mole. Similarly, at the exit of gas turbine also it is determined at T4. So from H4 and S4 it is 269,520 kJ per kg mole. The chemical exergy of the gas is determined from the gas composition of carbon dioxide, water vapor, oxygen and nitrogen, and also the partial pressures of this gas. So that is equal to 21,170 kilojoules per kg mole Kelvin. The total exergy is determined by adding chemical exergy and the physical exergy at each and every state. Exergy, the total exergy of air at the inlet of the compressor is determined that is equal to 3,960 kilojoules per kg mole. And total exergy of air at the exit of compressor is calculated as 268,840 kilojoules per kg mole Kelvin. And the total exergy of the gas at the exit of the gas turbine, exit of combustion chamber or inlet of the gas turbine is equal to 894,080 kilojoules per kg mole Kelvin. Finally, at the exit of the gas turbine, the total exergy of the gas is equal to 290,690 kilojoules per kg mole. From these values of exergy, the reversibilities of components are determined from exergy balance. Exergy balance means the total exergy before the process is equal to the total exergy after completion of the process plus reversibility of the process. So the for compressor, the total exergy at the inlet of the process is sum of exergy of the stream and work input to the compressor. The total exergy at the exit of the compressor is the sum of exergy of the stream at the exit and irreversibility. So the irreversibility of the compressor is equal to exergy at supply plus work input to the compressor minus exergy at the exit. That is determined 19.73 kilojoules after converting after using multiplication factor. Kilojoules per kg mole is converted into kilojoules. And the reversibility of the combustion, that is the second process, is coming as 333.97 kilojoules. And third component is the gas turbine, that is equal to 23.56 kilojoules. All these three formulas are used, determined, obtained from exergy balance of these individual components. At the exit of this turbine, the gas consists of some exergy loss. That exergy loss that is also considered here, that is as a reversibility of the exhaust gas, is 326.89 kilowatts. So the exergy efficiency, the gas turbine is a gas power plant, is 27.55%, which is the sum of output. Work output is also equal to exergy output and exergy input in the form of natural gas. There exergy of the fuel is considered as for the natural gas. The same formula also can be determined using the basic concepts of the thermodynamics. Just for comparative purpose, the results are shown here. Here the gas tables are not used. The basic relations of thermodynamics are explained in earlier, that you use here. Straight away the results are showing here. But the same data, but the different process, the methodology is different here. The resultant performance values are 32.2%. So the higher efficiency is generated in the basic thermodynamic concept. The efficiency generated using JANAF tables are less than the efficiency obtained in basic concept. So the error is decreasing using this JANAF tables. Similarly, the exergy also evaluated here, it is coming here around 33.98%. By comparing the fuel air cycles and using JANAF tables, the difference in thermal efficiency is 32.2% in fuel air cycles approach, and JANAF tables it is 26.18%. Similarly, the exergy efficiency is 33.98%, whereas in JANAF tables it is 27.55%. Thank you for your interest.